The International Space Station is open for commercial business. Another space station resupply mission successfully completed and making a virtual landing on the moon. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. The International Space Station is now open for commercial business. A new policy announced during a June 7th news conference at Nasdaq in New York City provides the opportunity for up to two short-duration private astronaut missions to the space station beginning as early as 2020 if the market supports it. The policy also, for the first time, includes prices for use of U.S. government resources to pursue commercial and marketing activities aboard the station. Our goal is to foster a robust ecosystem in low Earth orbit from which we can purchase services as one of many customers. This will allow us to focus resources on our Artemis missions to land the first woman and next man on the moon by 2024. Our commercial partner SpaceX completed its 17th resupply mission to the International Space Station on June 3rd. The company's Dragon cargo spacecraft, loaded with 4,200 pounds of valuable scientific experiments and other cargo, was released from the station's robotic arm at 12:01 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time and splashed down a little more than 5.5 hours later in the Pacific Ocean. U.S. Secretary of Education Betsy DeVos visited our Johnson Space Center in Houston on June 5th to highlight a program through which education leaders and employers are narrowing the skills gap between workers and in-demand jobs. During the visit, DeVos met with NASA leadership, had the opportunity to speak with our astronauts aboard the space station, and met with NASA interns interested in careers in aeronautics, science, and engineering. On May 31st, our Administrator Jim Bridenstine tried his hand at a virtual landing on the moon in the 10-story vertical motion simulator at our Ames Research Center in Silicon Valley. The cockpit design was configured like the Apollo Lunar Module, but can be customized to enable astronauts to train for future moon landings with the most high-fidelity feeling they can get on this planet. Congresswoman Anna Eshoo also took part in the visit to see how NASA in Silicon Valley is contributing to the effort to return to the moon by 2024. We've achieved a significant milestone in manufacturing the first large complex core stage that will help power our Space Launch System, or SLS, rocket on upcoming missions to the moon. Along with lead contractor Boeing, we've assembled 4/5 of the massive core stage needed to launch SLS and the Orion spacecraft on their first mission to the moon, Artemis 1. The Artemis program will send the first woman and the next man to the moon by 2024 and develop a sustainable human presence on the moon by 2028. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.